My letter to love. Even though I've written you so many letters in the past, this one has to be one of the hardest letters I've ever written, have ever had to write, because I never thought that God would put someone like you in my life.
Tori, my best friend, my boo bear, my love, and now, forever, my husband. I love you since 2015 for so many reasons. You've consistently shown me what true love means.
Who could have ever guessed that a call to AAA to a car for a woman I barely knew because I thought it was the right thing to do would have landed me a wife? LOL. You truly made me a better man, and I thank and love you for that. You've shown me that being who I truly am is all that matters, and that God and family are the most important.
You've been consistent through every storm, always patient and kind. By your side, I feel safe and protected. In your presence, I feel a peace that is unexplainable. You have been my encourager, supporter, provider, and protector. Your love has always helped me find a level of confidence within myself that I didn't know existed. I'm the best version of me because of you. It's such an honor to call you mine.
Saturday, October 18th is the day you came into my life, blessing me with the transformation you'd cover me with. For 2,939 days, you connected with me and allowed me to grow, allowing your love and respect for me to develop as we get to stand married in front of the people we care about the most.
It's such an honor to call you mine. The past 8 years with you has been the most incredible journey. We've had some amazing times on this journey, and we've also experienced the depths of despair. Through it all, by God's grace, we've only grown closer and stronger. As we embark on this next step of our journey together, in front of all our family and friends, here are my promises to you.
For 4,232,160 minutes, you've shown me grace, even when I didn't always deserve it. And although those days and minutes matter, none of those compare to the future we have ahead. You are the woman that I want to spend forever with. You are the person I will pour my heart, mind, body, and soul into. You are a light, positive, honest spirit in my life and for so many people. You've made our path clear, even when our direction was uncertain.
With God at the center, I promise to always put you first. I promise to be a source of peace and comfort for you. I promise to always greet you with a smile. I promise to always consider your needs before my own. I promise to be everything you could ask for in a wife. As we continue to grow our family, I promise to be the best mother I can be. And finally, I promise to never give up on us.
Your name means love. And as we marry here in Charleston, the largest slave port at one point where so many people lost their identity and name, I'm honored to restore and honor their sacrifice by marrying love and adding my name to yours. I guess I have one question for you, love. Are you ready for us to tackle this life together with no regrets, no doubts, no anger, all love, all joy, and all compassion forever? I love it.
Babe, our love story is my absolute favorite. And to think it's only just begun. I can't wait to see what the future holds for us. I look forward with anticipation of finding more ways to love you better. I've watched you grow and change so much, and I'm excited to continue to learn more about you as you are now and as you will be in the future. I vow to love you through every change and every stage of life, forever and always. Your bride.
Tori. if you would just repeat after me. I, Tori.
I, Tori.
Take thee, Charity.
Take thee, Charity.
To my wedded wife.
To my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
From better for worse.
For better for worse.
For richer for poor.
For richer for poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness or in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
To death us do part.
To death us do part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And thereto I plight thee my troth.
And thereto I plight thee my troth.
All right, release her hand. In Charity, take your right hand and grasp Tori's right hand. And repeat after me, Charity. I, Charity.
I, Charity.
Take thee, Tori.
Take thee, Tori.
To my wedded husband.
To my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poor.
For richer or for poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love.
To love.
To cherish.
To cherish.
And to obey.
And to obey.
To death do us part.
To death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
I therefore give thee my troth.
I therefore give thee my troth.
The ring, please. In the old story of God's covenant with Noah, God set a rainbow in the cloud as a token thereof, and said, I will look upon it that I may remember the everlasting covenant. As token of your covenant, as token of your marriage covenant, you have selected a ring of gold. Here, the ring or rings shall be given to me, placed them in my hand. Gold is precious among metals, fitly represented the precious ties that unite husband and wife. I want each of you to look upon this ring. You will notice that it is endless unless broken by an outside force. It is a fit symbol of an unbroken partnership of marriage which should continue unto death. Let the ring be a constant reminder of your obligations to each other and a mute incentive to the fulfillment, to their fulfillment. Tori, for as much as husband imparts to his wife his name and receive her into his care and keeping, I give to you this ring. Put it on the wedding finger of your bride and say these words after me.
Be shaking. All right.
With this ring, I thee wed. And with all my worldly goods.
And with all my worldly goods.
I thee endow.
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And
Charity, if you will repeat after me. With this ring, I thee wed.
And with all my worldly goods, I thee endow.
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen. Now at this time, Tori and Charity have selected the salt sand ceremony. And separate sets of friends. They represent all that you are and all that you will ever be as an individual. They also represent your lives before today. As these two containers of sand are poured into the third container, the individual containers of sand will no longer exist, but will be joined together as one, just as these grains of sand could never be separated and poured again into individual containers. So will your marriage be. As much as these persons have consented together in the holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before God in this company, and thereto have given and pledged their troth each to another, and have declared the same by giving and receiving a ring, and by joining hands, I pronounce that they are husband and wife in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Tori, you may kiss your brow. We end this ceremony with the African American tradition of jumping of the broom. Slaves in this country were not permitted to marry, so they jumped a broom as a way of ceremonially uniting. Today it represents great joy, at the same time serves as a reminder of the past and the pain of slavery. As bride and groom jump the broom, they physically and spiritually cross the threshold into the land of matrimony. It marks the beginning of making a home together. It symbolizes the sweeping away of the old and the welcoming in of the new. The sweeping away of all negative energy, making way for all things that are good to come into your lives. Mm-hmm. It is also called a support for the marriage from the entire community of family and friends. The bride and groom will now begin their new life together with a clean sweep.
Ready?
2, 3.
As around the sun, the earth knows she's revolving, and the rosebuds know the bloom in early May. Just as hate knows love's the cure, you can rest your mind assured that I'll.
To make the way in. First, we have Mr. and Mrs. Swindler, Mr. David Eda, and Ms. Joyce Brown. Let's give them a hand. Next, we're going to shout out the lovely bridal party.
On top of the world, me and my clique, I've got it up in mud.
Let's give it up as they make their way in, ladies and gentlemen. We have Ms. Monica Gaffney, Terry Ruffin, Samara St. Turin, Hattie Brown, Michaela Eda, Mackenzie Eda, Greg Noel, Sean Simpkins, David Talent, Chinley Harvard, and Clyde Gouler. And at this time, ladies and gentlemen, stand to your feet for the second time as I introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Eager.
Can't stop, won't stop, never. I was upgraded from the last one. I left for research, teaching, and I ain't taking a good thing for any twice. I was 23, 8 and 1. Now I'm about like 23, 8 and 1. It's like a game I'm always playing and her. I don't want to kill the food like it.
always keep it inside. You're the driving force in my life. Yeah. There isn't anything or anyone that I could be, and it just wouldn't feel right. If I didn't have you by my side. Oh. You were there for me to love and care for me when skies were gray. Whenever I was down, you were always there to comfort me. And no one else can be what you have been to me. You will always be, you will always be the girl in my life for all time. Mama, mama, you know I love you. Ooh, you knew I love you, mama.
Second time this evening, Mr. and Mrs. E.
Come rewind, girl, I get the money with you, make you mine. Give you love in every life, you make you mad. Give me love and make me nice, oh, nice, oh, nice, oh. I feel make you mine, oh.
Girl, I love you plus I never make you minus. If I let you smoke it, you gon' lose my lighter. If you paranoid, then I'ma spend the night.
You can get a love in every day. Time I dance with you, the money I go pay. For your love, I go pay.
Hello, everyone. My name is Gregory. Welcome to our Eddie family. And I am here to tell you that I love my brother. So, what I got? Okay.
Nah, but.
Most of us met Tori 2009. So all the groomsmen were connected. Tori's my first roommate outside of my original like four or five. He's a year older, balder. But what Tori gave us, we can never get back to Tori. Because Tori lived life for us outside of college before we could ever get there. Tori gave for me personally, every day that he was outside, he was like, oh, I'm doing this for you, so you ain't gotta do it. When you get out, I'll see you there. When I got out, we still wasn't there. It's like about 3, 4, 5. What year is it? 2022? We just got here. It's been 3 years, right? No, but seriously, Tori made sure that I kept my head on straight. He made sure that each one of us knew what real life was when we were walking out of college. And then October. And homecoming. We went to go see Samara. But we met Charity. And when we met Charity, Tori said, oh yeah, I'm coming with you. We're gonna go there. I'm not gonna tell you why he had to go there, because it was homecoming and I wasn't in my right mind. But when we got there, Tori decided that this was the journey he was gonna take. And Charity, who, this is my debate partner. The only thing that Charity and I agree on is when Tori's wrong. It's been like that for years and it'll never change. And Tori just looks at us like, y'all not gonna gang up on me. But the only thing that I know that all of us share is the love for each other and the fact that ever since we've met each other, it's been advancement. Charity has made Tori a better man. He's every step of the way. I watched Tori tell me that he was in love with Charity, that he couldn't do anything without her, that he was a better man, that he wanted to do better things. I watched Charity grow, blossom into somebody that I didn't know I never knew you could be who you are. And now I look at you like a little sister. Nothing will ever happen to you that I won't change. And Tori, I've never had a brother. I got plenty of them right now. And all I gotta say to end this is, please welcome me in saying that I love Mr. and Mrs. Torres, as you, Ada, and thank God that you guys got what you prayed for.
As Charity's maid of honor, I have a few words I'd like to share for the happy couple. Let's start by saying I'm the true reason why we're all here today.
What? You are wrong!
Listen, I am so happy for the both of you guys. It's been nothing but a pleasure to watch your love story. I can't wait to watch you guys blossom into marriage so beautifully. Charity, I gotta get my speech back. You are a beautiful person, inside and out. So happy our paths crossed. Thank God for Clark Atlanta University. It's been nothing but an absolute pleasure. Honor to be your maid of honor. I'm so happy that you found your person, Tori.
Tori, Tori! Told you!
That's Harry.
No, you didn't say it. Told you!
You are such a great man. Thank you for loving my friend. Y'all are both my friends. You and this. I'm the third party for life. You guys are my favorite couple. Love and happiness. Let's cheers to this beautiful couple.
So she's put this on me and said, thank you there. I guess she thinks since I manage hundreds of employees, I can publicly speak to people, but I don't know, I get nervous. Well, first off, I want to thank everybody for taking the time to come out and celebrate us. People traveling from California, traveling from Texas, traveling from Nigeria. You know, Delta State, you know, Lori, right? I appreciate you guys for taking the time to and having the money to come and celebrate us. It's really it really opens my heart to the fact that you guys have really taking the time to really do that for us. I really thank you for that. All the love you guys have shared this evening to bless our marriage, we thank y'all. I think as we go into this union, the love that y'all shared with us this night, the blessing that you provided into our marriage, we'll take that into our marriage to make sure that we're whole. And as this union, we're hoping to make sure that we are able to be an example for, you know, our friends and family to, you know, let them know that you can move forward and have that person in your life that is a light and that can help you shine and help you move forward. Being the person that I came from, I grew up in Los Angeles, California. And, yeah, LA, right? Yeah. All right, Miss House. Be where I'm at, you know, have the career that I have the wife that I have the friends that I have, took hard work. So if I can do it, anybody. So I say that to say, keep your hearts open. When it comes to love, and I'll say this every day, 100,000%, it's a choice. You have to choose to love the person that you're with. It's not a Disney fairy tale. No. This person that come into your life, oh my God, she's putting me off my feet. It's not about that.
I love you, Tori.
It's a duty. You have to choose to love that person. You have to pick that person, and you got to choose to love them with all the faults that they have. Because guess what? Nobody's 100% perfect. I'll say it again for the people in the back. Nobody's 100% perfect. So if you're looking for somebody that's perfect, you're not going to find it, bro.
Period.
You're going to be sad.
Period.
Right. You're going to be... What, I need to go ahead and for saying this. I'm about to say it.
First of all.
In the name of Kevin Samuels, you're going to buy a dog and die alone. Oh, yeah. I heard it. I did dead serious. But yeah, for real. Yeah, I know real people feathers in here, for real. But I'm dead serious. Like, it's a choice. And so I really thank everybody for taking the time to come and celebrate us. I love each and every one of you guys for shedding your blessings on our marriage. And honestly, we keep our hearts open in general. I'm a giving person. I want to make sure that everyone here is shed my love and shed my provision. So thank y'all. Charity wants to know.
I love you, Tori.
Let's pray.